Hello everyone, and thank you for joining me in Hearts of Iron 4. And in this series, we're gonna go and play the mod called Red Flood. Yes, Red Flood. I've never played this before. I don't know the rule. With the collapse of the Western Front, Russian Civil War, the revolutions that set most of Europe. Okay, liberalisms, blah, so... Futurists and socialists are on the rise, apparently. The Germans are the socialists and the French are the futurists. Futurists. Okay, so it's a very interesting time language. I'm gonna go ahead and play... play as the German Socialist Republic. Yes. So we're gonna play as Germany, or I have no idea. I'm just gonna make this Iron Man and the rest historical AI. And then we'll get, well, Prussia is independent. Prussia is independent. If it's not funny, I wouldn't know what to say. It's pretty funny. So guys, please like and subscribe and leave a comment what you think about this. If you haven't yet already. And well then, I would say let's get straight going into the game, shall we? Let's just go ahead and get rolling. Germany is the only socialist... country, interestingly. In 1905, Russia won a pyrrhic victory over Japan. Wow, so, okay, guys, I'm really looking forward to this. The focuses, the entire thing is also different. I don't know what you already researched. The symbols, all different. I'm just gonna get some basic things rolling. I suppose, we have some tanks, some air power, great, let's go. We already have it, so I just cannot differentiate it between them, so I don't know, let's get that. So, the focus tree of Germany looks like this, a pretty nice one if you ask me, and the question is, when can they attack someone? Attack someone. So I suppose, I don't know, what can I research? I can only do the order of the day. The 18th year dawns, and also this is Republic. Okay, let's go ahead and do that. And then I'll also suppose, let's build, well, military factories, right? Firstly, expand our infrastructure, and then. So if I see, we are led by a power levy, I have no idea. Why do we have minus 50% political power? That is pretty brutal. We are gaining almost no political power. So we see we are leading the Rot Front. The Rot Front, or interestingly, Poland is in the Intermarium, and they are accelerationists. The army is the equal size of ours, so no rushing Poland for now, I suppose. Götterdämmerung. Okay. Interesting. Well, let's see. Oh, Lenin dead, what just happened? Did the event kill him? Oh, he died of a stroke, okay. Okay. Where did he die? Well, alright, it's a late death though. A new KPD chairman, Karl Radek Heinrich Bradler. Well guys, the thing is, I have no idea whom to choose, who does what, and how they are. I'll just suppose that I'll just go and get Karl Radek, because I heard him from history, but I have no idea who it is. I just see I have 17 unassigned military factories. Well, I suppose it's time to assign them, right? So, yeah, it's just, I would say a third for our Air Force, since Air Force is very important in Hearts of Iron 4, and the rest maybe like this, I suppose. I don't want to bother with tanks, so this should be a-okay, I think. I can reconsult the radicals. Well, okay. But wait, we are revisionist socialist. What does that even mean, revisionism? What is revisionism, guys? Why, like, revisionism is bad, right? But what the hell is, why are we revisionists? I have no idea. with no idea. Really, I'm this first time I'm even playing this. Are those our puppets or what? No. No, right? Oh yeah, but I don't know why I can build it in that turf. That is odd. That's not something you can do in normal House of Iron. I suppose I just want to have 50. Just gonna build civilian factories until I get 50 of them, and then I'll build military. Okay. Mongolia declared war on the Anhui clique. What the hell happened to Asia? What the hell happened to India? Well, I suppose the British lost their Indian territories. There is a Commonwealth of Nations, for sure. With the British having mostly lost, it gained a few states here, a few states there. And then America is a little bit different, like Ecuador is larger. Peace at all costs. That's really interesting, guys. I've gotta read them through in depth because it looks really interesting. I don't know if I should do that or not. I mean, I don't want to be revisionist, okay? So maybe it's better not to be revisionist, although I don't know. I just don't know. I legitimately don't know what to do. Okay. Well, encourage discourse or... I mean, okay, I have to do both, so I suppose let's just do that. Lviv faces scrutiny. Well, that's quite a loss for him, or what just happened? Okay. Well, I can just select people. So, I don't know whom to get, I really don't know. I'll just get Anna Zegas, or this also seems nice. I'll just get the woman, let's just get her. Because, yeah. I don't know whom to take, Goebbels or Reventlow, Greater Germania. So let's get Goebbels for Greater Germany, because why not, right? And our party popularity is just 11%, it's not really high. What's this? The Beijing Compromise, white peace. The war just broke out. Oh, okay, it's a Japanese civil war. What the hell? The Weltenbrand. Oh, the KPD ruling party. Okay, so the SPD is no more. The communists won, apparently. So there we go. Now we are Leninists. We are Leninists. Okay, any elections by event? Well, there goes the SPD. The Japanese Civil War. Oh, interesting. I really like that you get this pop up. Well done for the mod. I really like the mod so far, I gotta say. We got a completely new focus tree. Okay, so the 20 minutes will be done pretty fast. Okay, so we can... The Bremenists in Berlin. The work of Lenin shall guide Germany into communism. Well, okay. Okay. In Korea, we have the Kingdom of Korea, Korean Republic, and the Korean People's Republic. So, well, the war and world danger still at zero. Alright. The French decided to attack Wallonia. Wallonia is basically unopposed, so it will be easy expansionist territory. While the accelerationist French, whatever that is. Okay. What the hell? So the beer rips itself apart. The summer coup war. Okay, so Russia lost its Russian Empire. Rut, it completely lost it. Okay, so Russia was controlling all of this, now it's just no more. It is. Well, let's form. Let's go ahead and form a new guard. What the hell is happening in the world? There is a war in every little corner. When will we fight our next war is the question. I don't know, so. The Arbeiter Congress. Well, I suppose we need troops. Because now we are in no position to attack the Austrians or to let alone attack anyone. Let's get the Volksschützen. Division, pretty expensive though. The Oriental Crisis, okay. So we got the Arbeiter Congress done. Let's do the Austrian situation. Red flag over Vienna. It's complete. Three future will be decided here. Okay. Well, let's declare war on them. they're being granted by Italy and Switzerland, so it would be quite difficult. We can reclaim Prison House or Pan-Germanism. Let's go ahead, get Pan-Germanism. Seems to be, you know, better, the better pick, right? So... got that. Now? Okay. With Pan-Germanism. Prepare for liberation. Okay, so we can what only attack them? What if Italy doesn't exist? Why? Maybe it's one of the two, but no, it says so. What? Well, that means Italy is going to rip itself apart, right? Oh, look, I can see into the future with the Focus 3 already. I'll just go ahead and research the path already to be ready. And another civil war. What the hell? What did it say? Papal anarchists? What? For national personal autonomy. The Spanish Civil War. Here lies half of Spain. It died of the other half. Okay. Well, let's do prepare for liberation. And now the KPR declared war on Korea. So, well, I suppose the Korean Republic will win because they are, you know, far stronger. Peace deal has been signed. Okay. Okay, well, cool. There's actually a Prussian Congo. What? Well, I didn't see that. There's a Prussian Congo. Okay, so, question is, how did the Prussians flee to Congo and what? And they are like an independent colony. Oh, then there is also Belgian army remnants. Okay, well, if that's not interesting, I don't know. Well, guys, really, like, I just want to fight someone, okay? I cannot see when we'll fight someone. I think we just gotta build up until 1939. And then I think we will, you know, basically, fight someone. So I think here we can fight the futurists. To deepen Polish ties. Well, okay, so we won't fight the Poles, apparently. We can fight the French only after 1940, so we just gotta wait until then, I suppose. Correcting Livy's error. What's this? Okay, so here we can fight Austria and Italy as well, I think. Yeah, so, well, I think it's gonna be the second episode, guys, if the time is right. But Austria is guaranteed by the Swiss. Well, I mean the Swiss, really, the Swiss. The Swiss! Like, they really want to get involved? Alright, if that's what they want. Well, guys, really, like, this mod is unlike any I've played before, and I'm still bloodthirsty. I mean, in 1939, I think, I don't know when we can declare the war. It says 1940 we can snuff out the light, but only if we fulfill this path. So only if we somehow establish the African Liberation Front. For that, Madagascar has to win. Oh, okay, so we need to help them. Well, let's do this, guys. Let's do this. Let's just send volunteers. We can just send one, really. Well, I mean, one is better than zero, right? Let's just send this Panzer. Is it worth it to send him? Yeah, he's too weak. Let's just send our basic infantry division. It's 12,400 troops in the field. So let's get Erich von Manstein to lead the charge. Boom. Also send. We can send up to zero airplanes, guys. We have permission. Send up to zero airplanes. Well, isn't that truly amazing? Suppose, meanwhile, is it worth even building infrastructure? I don't think we need to build an factory. Okay, Armenia just got really big now, and I don't know what happened to Turkey, but Turkey is kind of dead. They are really dead, and the Straits are even stronger than Turkey itself. I really hope that our one expeditionary force here will make a difference. Because there are like 100 ongoing wars. Let's see. Well, okay, so just one division makes a big difference, actually, if you think about that. It's like a fourth of their entire army strength. We just captured their capital now. That's pretty nice. So they lost their capital. Will they capitulate? That was the question. Well, let's defend it. But it's not enough to force them. Spain in our hearts, okay? Where is socialist Spain? Where is socialist Spain? They don't even exist. Okay, they actually exist, but I supported the wrong faction. Well, I don't think the socialists can win. I'm gonna stop supporting the commune. It's just... look, they got 10,000 of our weapons. No more weapons for them. Okay, yeah. Well, I have my divisions holding the wrong one. Well, as long as the accelerationists don't win, or I think that's okay. Well, now it makes sense. A prerequisite was that Italy does not exist. Well, Italy is fighting the League Solar, the Sun League, apparently. So, yeah, I think Italy will be snuffed out of existence very easily. So, thus, we will face a strong French Republic. But we will unite Germany for sure. The Rot Front will unite Germany. We have around 1 million troops in the field, but outbreak of the war, we should have more than 2 million. So that will be pretty amazing. The question is, how long can Italy endure the attack of the French? Not for long, I reckon. Not for long at all. Well, I'm already preparing my collaborationist government in France, so we can just annex them easily. The revolutionary government in Fiume has vanquished the government in Rome, marking a triumphant finale to the endeavor. Okay, what does that mean though? Well, Fiume, what is Fiume? What is Fiume? What the hell is that for a description? Okay. Accelerationist. Well, so much about Italy, right? The French have how many? The French have around 1 million. So it will be a struggle for our life, essentially. We'll defeat the French, and you know, I don't, well, it is not so beneficial, let's say, these new paps, so I really don't know what I risk and what I did. I'm just doing some things, random things, yeah. No. Alright. We can at least declare war on the Austrians now, correcting Levi's error. Yep, we're gonna declare war on Austrians, the Austrians are gonna surrender very, very swiftly, that is. What I'll do is, I'll just delete this battle order, because I want my army just to focus on the Austrians completely. We just need some troops, I guess the Swiss as well. That's how many? I can't even see what is selected. Okay, 18 should be enough. Yeah. Now we are correcting Levi's error. We will go forth and succeed in what Levi has had failed. We have many, many troops in training, but we don't need them, though we will crush the Austrians as they are. They cannot even fully man their front line. Let's see, if I would go ahead, let's just cancel the line of these. So, I think I can even deploy all of them. Should we deploy or let's just wait until the training is done and then deploy them. I'm gonna ready up my air force in the meanwhile. But when we correct Levi's error, that's gonna be the start of the second episode, actually. And let's see, okay, we declared war on the Austrians. Well, guys, I thank you all for watching me in this episode. It might be, I think it's gonna be a very easy war, but that's gonna be the second episode. So thank you all, guys, for what's this? So we played this together the first time. That's the first time I played this mod. So thank you for watching, and I wish you all a great day, and hope to see you soon. Goodbye, and have a great day.